Now, Access Tech Live headlines.
So let's start with Google. They've officially introduced Gemini, its generative AI-powered assistant, to Android and iOS in Canada. That means that Canadians can now download the Gemini app on Android or use it through Google Assistant. iOS users can also have access to Gemini via the Google app, with the rollout happening over the next couple of weeks. Now, notably, Canadian Android users have been able to sideload Gemini on the app for a couple months now. Alongside this, Google's expanded Gemini extensions, those are add-ons that make it smarter, and have added more language support to it and more country support to it, including French in Canada. Extensions allow Gemini to integrate with other Google apps and services, pulling real-time information. So if you use Gmail or Docs or YouTube and Google Maps, it can actually cross-reference all that information. The official availability of Gemini should make it more accessible, eliminating the need for workarounds to sideload the chatbot. If you're interested, you can download the Gemini app in the Play Store or Google app for iOS users right now. Lenovo's in the news in a move lauded for its consumer-centric approach. They've introduced accessibility features in its ThinkPad keyboards on their laptops. The design now includes raised bumps for effortless navigation and a reconfigured key layout to aid visually impaired users. Senior technologist Graham Thomas highlighted these updates in a conversation with Stephen Scott and Sean Preece on the Double Tap podcast.
Nowadays, the keyboard hasn't changed that much in terms of the number of keys and buttons, but what we're trying to do with that keyboard has increased. You know, we're not just typing letters, and there's a need to very quickly move to certain areas of the keyboard for functionality. So we've actually put more raised bumps across the keyboard. So the volume buttons on the function row, there's a smaller one for volume down and a bigger bump for volume up. There's one on the insert key, enter. There's also a slight change we've made in the bottom left-hand corner, but having a few more bumps around are enabling users to navigate around there easier.
Lenovo's commitment extends beyond ergonomics as it integrates AI capabilities into its diverse laptop range, catering to all users from budget-friendly idea pads to high-end Legion series. WeWalk is in the news and announcing their Smart Cane 2, featuring an AI voice assistant, advanced optical detection, and lighter, more functional design. The first iteration of the Smart Cane was pretty clunky, while this new one looks more like the traditional white cane and uses updated sensors for increased performance and tracking. The new cane is available for pre-order right now and will ship in June, and we'll hopefully get our hands on a future show. The Estee Lauder company and Microsoft are getting together to revolutionize prestige beauty with generative AI, focusing on accessibility and inclusivity. The partnership will see the creation of an AI innovation lab utilizing Microsoft's Azure OpenAI service to develop AI solutions that cater to a diverse customer base, including those with disabilities. The new lab will leverage generative AI to aid in the creation of products that are designed with accessibility in mind, allowing for rapid adaption and, of course, the needs of consumers with disabilities. This new collaboration underscores both companies' commitment to inclusive beauty, leveraging technology to create products and experiences that are welcoming and usable for everyone. Stephen, no longer will you have an excuse to not powder your face before another episode of Access Tech Live.
Hey, listen, you know, I know you're saying that flippantly, but I'm with you on this because that is a major issue. I think, well, I don't want to end up looking like Coco the Clown when I put on makeup. So, you know, to avoid that hassle, I don't do it. But if I'm able to do this, and this was the interesting thing, Estee Lauder last year came up with an app which used AI, and it wasn't just telling you about the type of makeup you could use on your face, it was actually directing you and helping direct you to put that makeup on, which is super cool. I've got to also mention the WeWalk Smart Cane. I have been known in the past couple of months to be talking about smart navigation devices and being a little bit down on them. The truth being, I just want to get a proper device that's actually, it feels as if the community of blind and partially sighted people out there are actually involved in its creation. That should be the case with any product made for a disabled person. Disabled people have got to be part of the process. It can't be something you design in your head and then put it down on paper, it becomes a prototype, and then we get hands-on with it. It has to be from the very beginning. And with the WeWalk Smart Cane 2, I feel that that certainly appears to be the case. One notable difference between the first edition and the second edition is the second edition you can use in the rain. You might think that's an important thing for a device when you're out and about, and it is. So, you know, for that reason, I'm kind of really welcoming a lot of these new adaptions and, of course, the AI functionality in there, the ability to speak and use GPT-4 on a cane. I mean, wow, that sounds so cool.
Yeah, that sounds pretty cool. And, you know, we focus a lot on new technology, but our question of the week this week is about old technology, Stephen, specifically outdated stuff. So our question is, what outdated piece of technology do you still use today, and why do you hold on to it? I think that's the important thing, to understand a little bit of the psychology as to why you can't let that old BlackBerry go, for example. So what outdated piece of technology do you still use today, and why do you hold on to it? Let us know at Access Tech Live on all our social media platforms. Pop it into the YouTube live chat if you want, or send us an email, feedback@accesstechlive.com, and you can get involved. Coming up, and folks in Ontario have been talking around the water cooler about this ban on cell phones in classrooms. After a break, it's our turn to dive in. We'll be talking to Karen Littlewood, the president of the Ontario Secondary Schools Teachers Federation, to get the teacher's perspective. Stick around.
There's more Access Tech Live to come. Get involved and have your say at Access Tech Live on social media. We'll be right back.